Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing the I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings novel Thai Study Guidebook by Maya Angelou. The writing is a little patchy with different styles occurring, perhaps because of parts being written at different times, and it ends very abruptly. This says a great deal about how so-called higher education in this country is not a great deal at all. While this is a unique book by a wonderful human being, it is not high literature. As biography, it certainly is engaging as uplifting reading. It serves to some degree as a testament to a black woman's triumph over racism and many kinds of adversity. It is warming and interfused with a comforting spirituality. It recounts but does not inspire, perhaps because the book is contaminated with a trace of narcissism. Honest and revealing in spite of how painful it must have been to relive Dr. All in all, this is a riveting tale of her struggles in society and her private life. Great guide with ample vocab, thoughtful discussion questions, and a nice balance between literal and inferential for the student. Her cadence is hard to get accustomed to at first, but as you find her rhythm, you fall under her spell. An interesting testament to life in the 30s for a young black woman in the South. This is a jewel written by one of the most famous and best-loved authors in the world. Maya Angelou knew how to write, obviously, and knew how to convey this tragic subject. Recommend for those who enjoy a well-turned paragraph that evokes a time and place. Isn't it interesting when people are experiencing specific challenges in their life, they might think it's all bad? A must-read for anyone trying to understand the experience of African Americans in the United States. Clearly written by an author who knows how to convey the impressions and perceptions of a child so well. There is nothing bad to say about this incredible book, an incredible story of a girl with amazing courage and strength. Her words are able to take you through the actual setting of what was taking place at a particular time. This story of a young black girl's perseverance is as captivating as it is tragic. Raw honesty, humor, and the unrelenting bonds of family connection all make this book a true classic. This is a timeless classic that never gets old. Love Maya Angelou and plan on purchasing all of her work. What a loss to humanity. Read this book before wanted it again for a friend to read. Story of Maya's younger life, nicely told, sad, glad, and uplifting all at the same time. The author uses very good vocabulary in writing this account of her life, which leaves a lot to be desired. They experience the prejudice of the South, the love and pain of family and life in general, and Maya's remarkable ability to turn these experiences into a great wisdom. The rich storytelling can transport you to a rinky-dink store in Arkansas, or a trolley in San Francisco, or even the back streets of SD. This book was an eye-opener. It touched on many situations, stories, and struck readers on different levels. It mirrored situations no different that black and white children as kids just love to be kids and the wonderment of life and growing up. The beginning is a bit slow, but as it continues it becomes engaging and difficult to put down. The book is fantastic. Everyone should read it in their lifetime, as well as MS. A well-written story which shows the possibility of finding a peace and harmony regardless of the tragedies or difficulties that life might present. If you want to get under the skin of racism and oppression in the early part of the 20th century in the U.S., the language is heart-rending and soul-searing at times. You can't help but pause and let the words slowly sink in. Many of her phrases capture the essence of what it is like to be human, such as few, if any, survive their teens. Other phrases beautifully capture the experience of oppression if growing up is painful for the Southern black girl. Being aware of her displacement is the rust on the razor that threatens the throat. This piece of literature is targeted for the adult reader, and it succeeds in recapturing Angelou's painful untold past. All in all, this book is definitely worth reading, especially if you are interested in African American literature, philosophy, psychology, etc., etc. Is there anything in it that an eighth grader shouldn't be able to handle? Not really. She certainly experienced a great deal of life as it was handed to her as a young black woman. It is an eye-opener and also a help in overcoming obstacles and staying strong. But what makes this wonderful book shine is the way in which Maya and her family and those around her face challenge and overcome these indignities. She is one who has overcome many hurdles in her life to have accomplished so much. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.